Hello everybody. I just felt the urge to come on and just say hello. So we are waking up after the death of our beloved Queen. And it seems quite strange to be saying at the beginning of the realm of King Charles III. Everything seems so different and so strange and unusual. And I just wanted to say hello to everybody and anybody else who, like me, has found I'm actually much more affected than I would have expected to have been, in view of the fact that I've got a very busy day happening today. And I thought my mind would be occupied with the things that I'm doing today, but my mind is occupied by the thoughts of what an incredible woman, what an incredible woman she was, of immense strength. And whether we agree or disagree, just to be able to carry on through. And, you know, she was only doing public duties only, you know, 2 days before she passed. You know, possibly within hours of her health changing. And, you know, as the family are assembling and being together, it's really made me think about my family and my mum and my nana and my granny and, you know, the strength of these ladies, these amazing strength of these super, super, super incredible women, and how it's gorgeous as a family of reflexologists. You know, we are very feely, we are very sensitive, we are very aware. And that's one of the things, you know, everybody was laughing about, you know, in the days when it was Prince Charles, about the fact that he used to talk to plants and trees. Well, I talk to plants and trees. I do. And, you know, in my world of feng shui, I so understood about, you know, the pointy architecture and things that he was ridiculed for not liking. And yes, people have made mistakes in their lives, and very big ones. But we have the beautiful Prince William, and what a support he will be to his father. And I'm just thinking about my boys and how grateful I am for my boys and how wonderful they are. And, you know, as times in, you know, in the world, and, you know, we're wanting to be there, I've had lots of messages from friends who've been quite deeply affected by this, but they're very private and not wanting to say that to anybody. One friend said, "I'm crying at home, but I don't want anybody to know." And so, you know, if there are any people out there who are, you know, privately feeling quite devastated and quite shaken and unnerved by change, then, you know, this is just a reminder that we're all here as a, you know, group of reflexologists or people who are interested in helping people and supporting people. And this is when, you know, we're needed more than ever, is to be there to help to do those beautiful techniques that we know and love. And, you know, whether it's we're teaching parents how to look after their babies, or whether we are doing the beautiful solar plexus techniques or the peace point or whatever those lovely techniques are that we're using to support people in the community. How great is it that we're able to be there, hopefully for ourselves with doing our own techniques on ourselves, and also helping people within our community. And maybe there are people in hiding who are deeply affected by this, and we can be there for them too. So I send lots of love to you. This is a world acknowledged event, so wherever I'm speaking to you in the world, I say hello to you. I send lots of love to you. I send my hugs to you. And just let's all come together and raise our energy and vibration. And I too will be going out to talk to the trees. And some of you may have seen my video earlier on of my beautiful place. And I'll be going there again today to talk to the trees. So in celebration of an amazing life and of an amazing woman, and of anybody who talks to trees. So lots of love, big hugs, and I love you. Bye-bye.